Are you here for the lesson on the central dogma? Well, come on, these proteins aren't going to make themselves. So, what is the central dogma of biology? Well, essentially, it's all about how our bodies make proteins for us to use. And we make them out of our DNA. Most people are familiar with DNA. You get it from your parents, and it can determine a lot about how you look and function. But not as many people are familiar with RNA. This is the stranded cousin of DNA. RNA helps our bodies by copying DNA. But if we already have the instructions for life in our body, why do we need to make a copy? Well, imagine you have a cookbook, and you want to remember a recipe. You aren't going to copy down the entire cookbook. There's way too much information. Instead, you're going to go to the recipe you want, and maybe copy it down on a recipe card. That's essentially what happens in our bodies, in a process called transcription. We don't copy our entire genome. Instead, we get RNA polymerase to only copy a small section. Well, we've copied the mRNA that we need. Now what? Now it's time to start phase two, translation. Now, before we can make a protein, we need a ribosome. We can't use an actual ribosome because they're microscopic, but we can use a model of one. A ribosome has a large subunit and a small subunit, with a spot in between for an mRNA to go through. We also have tRNA, which goes into these different sites and slowly builds up a chain of amino acids, until eventually we have a long enough chain to make a protein out of. But this process is a bit complicated, so I think I have a better way to explain it. Welcome to the ribosome kitchen, where we have everything we need to make a protein. We have our cooking instructions, which represents our mRNA, our bowl, which represents our tRNA, our ingredients, which represent our amino acids, which I guess means I represent the ribosome. So now, we can start the process of translation. Done. We have our protein. Well, not quite yet. There's still a few more steps that need to happen before we have a fully functioning protein. So I guess that means it's time to put this in the oven.
When a protein is built, the different amino acids and the different molecules in it react with each other due to different electrical charges or polarity, and it twists it into a very specific shape. And once it's done, it'll have a shape that fits its job in the body.
This process of building proteins is essential for our construction and survival, so it's important that our bodies get it right. Just like with a recipe, pinning in the wrong ingredients or too long in the oven can yield undesired results. But hopefully, this process goes perfectly, and we end up with a functioning protein.